Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bone. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Saint Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. That song has absolutely nothing to do with today's movie. I just like singing. Which sometimes gets me in trouble at work. My workmates aren't as appreciative. But sometimes, damn it, like a musical, you just have to burst into song. Today's movie is Open Water, about two scuba divers who are on a scuba diving trip doing their scuba diving thing, and everyone leaves without them. So they're stranded in open water, and hopefully someone finds them before they drown or get eaten by sharks. Will they make it to the end of the movie alive? Probably. I hope not, but probably. Hopefully someone at least loses a foot. Is this based on a true story? I honestly don't remember. Don't care. So I have no idea what happens. I am kind of concerned, though. From what I understand, this movie is two people floating in the water, trying not to get eaten, hoping to heck a boat comes by and picks them up before they die. Now, I've heard this is a very well done, very tense movie. And I certainly hope it is. I'm somewhat concerned that these two people are going to be insufferable, and they're just going to bicker and snipe at each other, and you're just going to hope that they get eaten by a shark sooner rather than later. But hopefully they're awesome characters that I care about, and hope they end up in one piece at the end of the film. Let's find out. It's okay. The movie's a little over 10 years old, so full spoilers. They both die. Neither of them really get eaten by sharks, though. They both do get bit. They also get stung by jellyfish. The girl gets tagged very mildly. The guy later gets a nice chunk of his leg taken out and bleeds to death. And then she pushes his corpse away, and the sharks go... And she watches the feeding frenzy, and then she takes off her tank, and then just submerges under the water. I guess she just drowns herself. Kind of a downer ending. So if this is based on a true story, I guess two people died. That sucks. This is one of the ugliest movies I have seen in a while, and what I mean by ugly is I mean the way it's shot. And it may be on purpose. I imagine the director is going for kind of a home vacation video aesthetic. You know, it's supposed to look like it was shot on someone's camcorder, everything's handheld, it's all up in people's faces, the video quality is absolute garbage. Unfortunately, it doesn't make a very pleasing watch. It's just an ugly movie. And the soundtrack. Oh my god. I actually yelled at the movie at some point. I said, "Stop!" A lot of the soundtrack consists of a song of people humming. and there are some lyrics to it later, but it's like, oh, just stop. So how did this happen? Also the couple is not annoying. I didn't really care about them. They're just an average couple, so average that you wouldn't notice them. So I never really, oh, are they gonna make it out all right? 'Cause they're not hateful, they're not obnoxious. They're fine. Just not really memorable or interesting. I just didn't care. They do have a row, but it's after they've been floating around for 7 hours. Tensions are high, you can understand that. So they go out on a scuba trip, and the scuba boat has 20 people on it. The guy does a head count, and he writes down 20. And then people go in the water, and he counts them as they come back in. Now, one guy forgot his snorkel mask, so he doesn't go in the water. So the first two people that come back on the boat, he goes, okay, there are three people on the boat. And then the guy borrows one of the person, the snorkel mask of one of the two that come back on, and takes one of them back in the water. So as more people, so that's where your two are. That's how the two get missing. So as people come back in the water, he counted two people twice. Which really makes no sense. First of all, I've been on things like this. They're a lot more careful about their head counts. But hey, maybe it was a cheap snorkel or scuba dive thing. but there's three people on the boat. There's the guy bitching about how his snorkel mask is missing. And then two people come on. He goes, okay, there's three people back on the boat. And the guy pitches a whole, makes a whole scene about, oh, let me borrow, come on, let me borrow your snorkel mask and you come with me because we got to do the buddy system. There is no possible way he could not have noticed this. Oh, two people got back in the water. Well, scratch those two. There is no way, no way he could have possibly not seen this. Now, I spend a lot of time on the internet, so I believe that there are people on this earth stupid enough to actually, for it to not register. Even our two people who are floating in the water mention they've got to come looking for us. I mean, not only is our stuff still sitting on their boat, we've got their tanks. Nope. Apparently, they pull in for the day. They go out at in the morning, and the boat leaves them at about 10:30, 10:45 in the morning. I guess that was the only tour that boat did that day, because they don't bother checking. They find the gear and stuff the following morning. Kind of unbelievable, but you wouldn't have a movie otherwise. And hey, I guess stuff like this does happen. Is it tense? It can be. It's mostly just kind of boring. About as boring as it would be floating in the water for a day. There is a nice shot towards the end of the movie where they're spending the night. And it's just pitch black, and it's only illuminated every time there's a lightning strike. It's a pretty cool scene. There's a lot of cutaways to, meanwhile, back at the ranch. They'll cut, I guess because they figured you need a break from two people bobbing in the water, but they cut to stuff that's completely meaningless. Meanwhile, somewhere else, other people you don't know are doing stuff. Yeah. Kind of assumed that was the case. It doesn't really do much to cut back to, are they going to find out that these people are missing and mount a rescue? Not really. And keeping it from the perspective of the two people bobbing in the water is interesting. Because then you, as the audience, like the people in the movie, don't know if they noticed they were missing. But I think the filmmakers figured they'd better cut to something because there's no way we're gonna stick with these two for the entire movie, which isn't that long. It's only 1 hour 20 minutes. Honestly, it could have been about 20 minutes shorter. I don't recommend it. I think it's an ugly movie. It's got a terrible, terrible sound. That kind of terrible. And it's just a little boring. And I just spoil it. They both die. There's some other weird stuff about this movie. When they first surface, they're between two boats, and they never try to swim at either one. And they're like, well, what if we swim at the wrong boat? Then we'd have to swim all the way back. It's like, no, you get on the boat, and I'm sure, I mean, unless you've got, like, pirates or something, they'll probably happily drive you over to the other boat, and at least you're out of the water. There's a scene where they're like, oh, look, a boy. And they swim for the boy. And then that scene just kind of stops. And I'm like, what about the boy? Could you not make it? Did the current pull you in another direction? Did we just forget? I mean, there are, I think, shark attack shenanigans that they get, but once that's taken care of, are we giving up on the boy? There's a lot of little things like that in the movie that just, I'm like, wait, where are we? What are we not doing this? What happened to this? 12 hours in the water, and she's like, "Oh my God, I've got food on me." You just remembered that? Really? I didn't like it. See you tomorrow.